My name is Margaret Ann Windsor, and that's the name, my real name. The name I have to use is Peggy Ann Childers, Dempsey Childers. I married a Childers. I was kidnapped in 1941 from Buckingham Palace and brought to Moulton, Alabama, and dumped on in a pigsty is what it amounts to. I'm not going to go into that because I got it on prior YouTube and on Facebook, a lot of it. I will say this, I didn't find out until after I was flown out to Larry Flint's in 83. I ran in a U.S. congressional campaign to replace Larry McDonald, congressman whose plane was shot down by the Soviets or Russia. It veered out of airspace into theirs, and all aboard died August 31st of 83. 10 years later, this is involving mind control, how you can, the pilot can be under mind control and it causes him to veer into another space and get shot down. And Larry McDonald, congressman, doctor that I'd written about, by the way, Emory University and CDC was in the book too that never got published. Obviously, I had antifreeze put in me April the 1st of 80. And it goes on and on, a letter from the FBI, June the 23rd of 79, ongoing investigation, national security involved. Well, I didn't know what they meant by that. I thought it was the people in the book, the doctors, and part of it was. And then it was my kidnapping. And when I was flown to Flint's, who was shot, and the person was programmed, that's what I was writing about. That have people are being programmed and modify their behavior or program them to shoot and kill in one or two or a mass. And you can imagine where it's at now. I mean, you got mass mind control. They can have armies go against each other that are under mind control. And believe me, that's not fantasy. That's the truth. But anyway, Larry Flint, the person that shot him, was programmed, and I'm flown out there. And I may be redundant, but the first thing he said to me was, "You don't have to tell me anything. I already know all there is to know about you." And he said they were going to send you back a vegetable, and back, which I hadn't found out. It was a little later. By the way, his limo driver was with British Intelligence, though, but I didn't connect it, you know. Then, it was a little later I found out about my kidnapping. But anyway, they were going to send me back to England, a vegetable. They'd kidnapped me, the monarch, Victoria II. They took down my father, the United States Roosevelt, the Kennedys, they make out to be heroes. The Illuminati, Rothschilds, the Jews, Rockefellers, took down my father, who was married to my mom, Claudia Ruth O'Keefe, from America, Irish, Catholic, and they orchestrated it. The British people are the ones that helped me, and I only can hope that I can somehow repay them, being the position to. This is my father, was never married to Wallace Simpson. She was an American spy who married, and they took the title of my father, who was the king. But it was Wallace Simpson married an imposter, a double, and my own uncle, who's meeting with Roosevelt. The year I was born, 39, so getting together on my kidnapping, I would suppose, not suppose there were. What I wanted to say, you can't tell the things they've done to me on a daily basis that are so illegal and so painful. But the one thing I want to get to when I came up here in 86 to Roanoke, and I didn't connect at that time, nobody had told me that I had an immune disorder, that if I'm around chemicals, you have to inhale chemicals, or that's what you're doing. It's that part of me that if I inhale certain chemicals or odors or fumes, that it makes my immune system attack itself. And it's according to the length of time. You have to get away from it. There's no cure for it. You have to get away. It causes inflammation, and over the years, all the inflammation, if you can't get away from it, It tears down every organ in your body, the liver, the kidneys, you name it. So I have told everybody, I have begged. The doctor, by the way, that told me that, and it all made sense then, and that's what I'm being treated for, the inflammation. And what happens when I'm force-fed it, and that's, to put it bluntly, and if you say it, you're afraid, well, they're going to try to say I'm paranoid or something. It doesn't matter what you show. Nobody doubted it. But anyway, the doctor that told me that back in 08, I already had an inkling of it, but I was in the ambulance taking me to the emergency room, and they pulled in at urgent care. And I'm told that he had his license or number, Medicaid, or Medicare license, I can't remember which, one or the other, he had it pulled for a year because of his involvement in helping me. Well, instead of people getting out and marching and getting attorneys or putting it in a magazine, getting it published, they've done nothing but go after me, just get me on down the road, shut me up. Anyway, chemicals have been put everywhere I've gone, it's controlled, where I live, affordable corporate suites, how many times. I've tried to leave here, I've been forced to come back. Where I'm at right now is owned by the Patels and Shaws. They own everything around here. When I came here, they didn't. And I'm going to get this in real quick because this is going on now. And my body and my health and what it does to me, I mean, imagine feeling like you're getting soaked all the time with chemicals. You have to inhale it, and that's the problem. You have to get away from it when it's in your house or home or apartment. You can't. You're forced to inhale it. Ventilation system, or if they come in and soak the bed with, or the, if the maintenance has been the main one in all this because they do the air conditioning and heating, ventilation system, all this, or if they come in and caulk, just find a, they don't even have to have a reason. But this is where I am now, and I'm going to have to leave. I mean, I really cannot, I'm going to be helpless if the mess isn't stopped. I feel so much better when I'm able to get out. The few times this year I did get out in camp and felt so much better, but now that I'm in really bad shape, and this is assault, and they get stuff on whoever participates with them, the law enforcement, they get stuff on them, and people do it. And I've heard them say, well, I don't want my child abducted. Well, if I help you, my bank account will be closed down, et cetera, et cetera. So this is where I'm at now, but I wanted to use this as an example. This was in November of 95. I'd managed to get a live-in and save a little bit of money. First I'd had, I'd been living on the Appalachian Trail for a long time, and then after then, freezing and starving. But anyway, I moved in, which is really down the street from me now. It's been torn down, but it was kind of nice, the apartment. It was kind of an apartment. It was called Budget Inn, and it was owned by the same people that's here. And I told him about me being chemical. So I knew back then about being chemical before that was allergic to chemicals. I knew the paint and caulking. I just didn't have a term about my immune system at the time attacking itself. So anyway, I paid a month's rent, and that's what's been going on. If I paid a month's rent, I'd be there two or three days, and they'd come in, and nobody's going to touch it. I don't call the cops because they're the ones, the law enforcement are the ones doing it, telling them to do it. So anyway, at the Budget Inn, I was talking about that he was going to come in, the manager, after I told him, or owner, it's part of the whole, the people from India, but the corporate suites who have flourished too, they own a whole bunch of stuff too since I've been here and have been a party to this mess. He's Jewish, quite wealthy. I wish people could see behind closed doors at what has gone on. It's sick. But the Budget Inn, when the cop came, they were going to come in November of 95, and it's cold here in Virginia at that time, and they were going to remodel. And I said, I told you that I was allergic to chemicals. And so I called the cops. Well, the cop came out and he said, "I'll arrest you." And he put my hand.